Hello everyone, I'm the Gaming Leaf, and in this video, I'll be telling you how to get better at BRM5 PvP. PvP is a very challenging game mode for new players in Black Hawk Rescue Mission 5. The reason why it's hard is, well, it's PvP, player versus player, so that means you're fighting against real humans, not AI. Because of this, PvP may be hard to you, and I'm going to tell you how to get better at PvP. First, I'll be telling you what types of weapons you should use. You don't have to use these types of weapons, but they are pretty good for PvP. The first type we'll be looking at will be carbines. Carbines usually have a high fire rate and moderate damage. Some carbines that I recommend are the M4A1, the MK or Mark 18, and the DWF416A5. But I highly recommend the M4A1 as it's cheap and it's a great starter weapon. The next type we'll be looking at will be assault rifles. Assault rifles have moderate fire rates and pretty high damage. These weapons can be used for close quarters combat and mid-range combat. Assault rifles do have long-range capabilities, but aren't that reliable in long-ranged combat. Now, we'll be moving on to submachine guns, but they are more commonly known as SMGs. SMGs have very high fire rates, but have low damage. These weapons usually have pretty high recoil, so I recommend using these at close range and point blank. SMGs aren't that good in long-ranged combat, but they are still able to do some damage. Some SMGs that I recommend are the MP7, the MP5, and the P90. Also, in a PvP match, if someone catches you using an AA-12, everyone will hate you and there are no exceptions. So just make sure to watch out for that. Now, we'll be going over some tactics to help you win in PvP. First, we'll be looking at defense tactics. These tactics should be used when you are defending the objective against the enemy team. The first tactic I'll be explaining will be positioning. Always, always position yourself near the objective when defending. I've lost countless rounds because me or my teammates were on the other side of the map when the objective was being secured. So, make sure that you are near the objective when defending. You don't have to be right next to it, but you should be close enough so that you can kill the enemy if they try to secure the objective. Now, we'll be looking at our second tactic, map knowledge. If you've played BRM5 long enough, you can easily predict where the enemy will come from. This is because of map knowledge. Map knowledge is gained by playing the game. Once you've played on a map long enough, you know where the enemy can come from, therefore allowing you to prepare. Map knowledge is a vital skill in defending, so you won't die getting ambushed from an enemy flanker. Now, we'll be moving on to offense tactics. First, we'll be looking at covering. Covering means covering your teammate. If your teammate gets shot at, you're going to shoot back from another angle. This means that the enemy is getting shot at from two directions, so you can rush the enemy while your teammate shoots at them. Obviously, your teammate is most likely a random person, so you won't get this amount of coordination, but your teammate is part of your team, so you want to keep your teammate alive for as long as possible. Now, for our second tactic, we'll be going over ambushing. This can be used as a defense tactic as well, but from my experience, it's pretty good with offense as well. Ambushing is a very good counter to flankers trying to secure the objective and can be used to kill any enemies defending the objective. Ambushing is all about stealth. I recommend fast-firing weapons such as the M4A1 or the P90 to quickly kill any enemies unlucky enough to get ambushed. If you want to ambush, use a dark uniform, such as gray, black, or dark green uniforms to blend in with your surroundings and not get caught. Well, that's going to be the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed, and if you want to support my channel, like and subscribe. Well, thanks for watching, and have a good day. Leaf out.